Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of Nick Drinks. I'm your host, Nick Britsky. We are back in the studio tasting some lovely products.
Nick Drinks.
And joining us is Ricky Tater, who is the brand manager of Nativo Rum. Hello.
Hello. Thanks for having me.
Of course. Thanks for coming out. So you're based out of Rochester, New York?
We are. We're based out of Rochester, New York. We have a portfolio of several different spirits brands, but Nativo is the newest member of our portfolio.
And launching in Michigan.
And launching in Michigan, yes.
That's great. So this is a Panamanian rum. What makes that different from any other rum?
Well, I guess the most important part of the fact that it's from Panama is, well, there's a couple different things. It's the sugar cane, right? Rum, obviously the sugar cane is one of the most important right. parts of it. So the region, the climate, the terroir of Panama, it helps to grow incredible sugar cane. Yeah. And the second part is the aging conditions for the barrels, mm-hmm. right? So we know that Kentucky for whiskey is a really good climate for aging whiskey barrels, bourbon yep. barrels. It's similar to that in for rum. The heat puts an enormous amount of stress on the barrels, on the whiskey, and it impacts a great flavor.
Which is good because you want that heat to kind of pull the juice into the barrels, right?
Exactly. Yeah. Yep. In with heat, out with cold, right?
And we talked about, rum is having such a crazy moment right now. There's a lot of great brands and a lot of buzz and excitement about it. But one of the things is some of the adulterations you can do to rum. We look at this is a pretty dark rum. Does that mean you're coloring it with caramel?
No, absolutely okay. not. Every bit of color that you see in there comes from a wooden barrel.
Which I feel like is pretty unique because it feels like a lot of the brands are kind of cheating the system and you're trying to do it the old-fashioned way.
You know, we've been getting a lot of questions about that. Okay. I'm not sure what it is about the rum category, but yeah, that's one of the first things people ask is, okay, why is that color so amazing? if you look at the 20-year, it is just incredible mahogany color, and it's all from a wooden barrel. 20 years in a wooden barrel.
So let's talk about, is this the full line?
This is it for now.
Okay. Yep. So talk about the three that we have.
Sure. This one spinning around to the front here is the 15-year-old. So what you see there is what we're calling true age, meaning non-Solera system. Okay. Other rums that you see out there that have a certain number that it's indicating a certain age means it's going through the mm-hmm. Solera system. These are not. These are at least 15 years old, but it could stem from anywhere 15, 16, 17, 18 years blended together to hit the flavor profile that we want to okay. reach. And then coming around is the 20-year. And it's the same rum, just, 5 years older, right? and it's the same story there. It's every bit 20 years and then a blends of even older rum to get to that flavor profile.
Okay.
And the last one that'll come around here in just a second is the red label is the overproof. Mm-hmm. It's 108 proof, wow. which sounds pretty hot. But everyone that tries it says, wow, I can't believe that's 108 proof. It's very, very smooth for being 54% alcohol.
And when you think of from a mixing perspective, the higher proof allows you to get more bang for your buck. So you can kind of dilute it with juices and flavors and still get that higher proof.
That's exactly right. That's the intention of the overproof product. It's an on-premise item. It's somebody at home mixologist that can mix up some great cocktails with it. And obviously the price point's a little bit better than, a little more attractive than the 15 or 20 year too.
And you can light it on fire?
You certainly can. Yeah. I've never done it, but we can try it today if you want to.
All right. Well, why don't we start with the 15?
Yeah.
So talk about what we're going to be tasting in this.
The 15-year-old, just getting a quick nose, you get I get a lot of cherries. I get a lot of the wood, a lot of the same oak kind of qualities as you would get vanilla mm-hmm. that you would get from a whiskey.
Yeah.
And then after you sip it, I think you'll see that a lot of those same nose characteristics will come through in the flavor.
Well, thank you for coming out.
Yeah, thank Cheers. You.
Mm. I mean, it's like intense brown sugar, like creme brulee. And the spice characteristics, a little bit of like darker, heavy baking spices.
Yeah.
The wood is there, but it's not overpowering. It's not like you're chewing on that stave.
Right. Yeah, it's
That
there.
Is quite pleasant.
That's nice.
Yeah.
It gets better. I'll tell you that. Gotta warm up your palate a little bit here. Get any fruit? Some people say banana, cherries.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I mean, now you're just planting all those flavors in my head right now. yeah. yeah, like pitted fruits. Dark cherry. maybe a little toasted coconut. Boy, is that good though.
It's good.
Really, really easy sipper. So I think one of the other things that we do, has the prices been set for Michigan?
Yeah, we're going to be on shelf most of the time, I guess, around $39.99.
Which is great.
For the 15 year.
That's great. $39.99. Excellent. Okay, good. I'm really digging that. Yeah. Well, this is wonderful. This is really good.
Glad you like it.
That's a great value as well.
Yeah, we've had some really good feedback on the 15. It won, you know, best of show at the Miami Rum Renaissance Festival.
Okay.
Pretty sure there's some good rum drinkers down there know what they're talking about. So we're pretty pleased with that. And then the 20 year here.
Absolutely.
Can I open it first?
Please, yeah. So one of the things you mentioned earlier was the Solera method. The way the Solera method works is you kind of add all the different years into a bigger batch. And then as you kind of fill them into the barrels, you keep adding. So you're like layering upon layering upon layering. It's very traditional in sherry, and it's used in a couple other things.
Yeah.
But by doing that, the youngest one in there to have that age statement of 15, that's the youngest you can be.
Right, exactly.
So if you keep adding, you can't add an 8, or all of a sudden you become an 8-year-old.
That's right. So we don't say that we're using the Solera system, but there's a lot of rums out there that are.
Got it.
Right. So we say that we're true aged 15 year, but we have a few other, you know, years that are older than that. So to your point, the youngest thing in there is 15 years or 20 now that we're drinking 20 years.
And so there's a little blending that's going on too, right?
There is, of course. Yeah.
Let's talk a little bit about the blender. Yeah. I think there's some great things that are happening with that.
Yes.
Explain about them.
Our master blender down in Panama is an amazing guy. His name is Don Pancho Fernandez.
Oh my God.
And he comes from Cuba, and he worked on a very, very popular brand in Cuba for a number of years. Yeah. I'm sure most really, we know, it's he knows what he's talking about.
Sure.
This guy is amazing. So he was, we were fortunate enough for him to share his skill and help develop Nativo rum. But what he does is pretty unique. Takes a number of different barrels and literally tastes each one and sets the batch based on what he's tasted out of those barrels. And when he puts them in the barrel, what he does is he sets them at different proof levels. So they're not all at the same proof when they're going in the barrel. And that allows him to be a little more creative and flexible when he's making his final batches.
So these are kind of the mass distributed bottles. Do you think he'll do any like single barrel or unique things like that?
I do think he's going to do some things like that. Yeah, certainly. And I know we have a 20 year, but I think down the road there might be some older stuff coming down too.
That's great.
Yeah, we're really excited about that. But I mean, these three have been getting great reception so far. We're really pumped. This is the first time it's going to hit the market.
Cool.
In these last couple weeks here.
That's great. And this one also has some medals in San Francisco.
Yes, the 20 has a gold medal in the San Francisco show. And there's another show called WSWA, which is a industry trade show, but still a very substantial judging panel on this. And the 20 year won best of show.
That's great.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, so
cheers to that.
Thank you.
Cheers to coming to Michigan. So it's like the 15, but intense and concentrated, like no heat.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. None.
Wow. I get a little more of the wood. I get a little more, like pleasant bittering agents, a little bit of that fruit there. I'd say the fruit has taken a little more of the backseat to maybe some of the spice.
Yeah.
Still incredibly pleasant though. And more complex, I would say, than the first one. This is like, and maybe this one wakes up a little bit more, but this one's definitely like, all right, I'm awake. Yeah. Let's party. Let's get to business.
Right. Yeah. Certainly, the 20 year has a amazing nose, and then the taste is like a different, completely different experience. Like
absolutely, yeah.
So it's definitely a unique product. Very different than the 15 too. Mm-hmm. So it's not like you're just enhancing it by a little bit. It's a very different product.
How can people find out more about the product?
There's a couple of different ways. I mean, I think the best thing to do is to go into your local retailer and just ask for it. This is brand new to the Michigan market. It's going to take a couple of weeks for us to really start getting the ball rolling. And as soon as someone hears from the customer that they want something, they're going to bring it in.
Right.
So that's number one. Number two is check out nativorum.com. A lot of cool things, information on the brand on there, cocktails, recipes, things like that. And of course, you can follow us on Instagram at nativorum and see, more things that we're doing on there.
Thank you so much for coming out. Yeah. Appreciate it.
No.
Welcome to Michigan.
Thank you.
And if you like more of these videos, you can check us out at nickdrinks.com, youtube.com/nickdrinks, and on Instagram at nickdrinks.com, all spelled out. Thank you so much. Till next, everyone. Cheers.
Cheers.